Let's take a quick look at some of this newer-ish information that's been coming out over the past couple of weeks. Jeffrey Epstein reportedly paid doctors to medicate, quote, sex slaves. I wonder if these, quote, doctors are being investigated. I mean, if they knowingly drugged underage rape victims, you'd think that should at least be looked into, right? Victims of multimillionaire pedophile Jeffrey Epstein said he paid doctors and psychiatrists to prescribe them tranquilizers and antidepressants, a report said Friday. Virginia Gouffray, who was recruited by Epstein at the age of 16, told the Miami Herald that doctors prescribed her Xanax for the 3 years she was abused by him. The financier provided medical care for his sex slaves using his recommended doctors. There were doctors and psychiatrists and gynecologist visits. There were dentists who whitened our teeth, she told the newspaper. There was a doctor who gave me Xanax. What doctor in their right mind who is supposed to protect their patients gives girls and young women Xanax? Right, that's what I'm saying. Sarah Ransome, who was 22 when she was trafficked by Epstein from her native South Africa, said she was taken to a psychiatrist and prescribed lithium when she was on the verge of a mental breakdown. You could see it in our faces. We were damaged. We were medicated, she told the Herald. The prescriptions for the victims were part of what lawyer Bradley Edwards called the Epstein process, the Herald reported. Edwards, who is suing federal prosecutors in South Florida over their handling of Epstein's sex trafficking case in 2008, described the process as psychological manipulation by Epstein. He would find out they have no home, no car, that they needed a place to live, and he would provide a place to live, Edwards told the Herald. He can get you to the best doctors. I'm just speculating here, but I get the impression that the extent of this drugging was probably a lot worse than what's being reported right now. Or at least I should say, I think it's possible there could be a lot more to it than just the details that they're talking about here. But let's switch over to some news about Prince Andrew and check out this piece. We're not going to read this whole thing, we're just going to talk about little bits and pieces that we haven't seen reported in too many other places. So, Epstein accuser says Prince Andrew told her, "Thank you," after she was forced to have sex with him. It's like they're afraid to say it for whatever reason. The dude raped her and then said thank you afterwards. A woman who claims Jeffrey Epstein paid her to have sex with Prince Andrew says in her first TV interview that the Duke of York thanked her after their first sexual encounter. He was an abuser. He was a participant, Virginia Roberts Gouffray says of Andrew in an interview with NBC Dateline set to air Friday night. The interview with Gouffray includes five other Epstein accusers, including three who were speaking publicly for the first time. Now, there's good reason to believe that there was over 100 victims at this point. If anyone out there hasn't read the documents yet, you can check out our other series where we go through almost every relevant page and read them for you. This number of over 100 is confirmed by actual employees who worked at just the island alone. So, Gouffray repeats accusations she has made in court papers that when she was 17 in 2001, she was forced to have sex with Prince Andrew. A photo released by a New York appeals court in August shows Andrew with his arm around Gouffray's bare waist. Gouffray says it was taken in the apartment of Epstein's longtime girlfriend, Ghislaine Maxwell, in 2001. If you follow Sean Atwood, then you know that this is almost definitely Ghislaine Maxwell's apartment that the photo's taken in. Okay, we already know about a lot of this other stuff, so let's just kind of skim through the rest of this here, because we got a few more to get to. The first time in London, I was so young, Gouffray tells Dateline. Ghislaine woke me up in the morning and said, "You're going to meet a prince today." I didn't know at that point I was going to be trafficked to that prince. Gouffray says that night she went to a London hotspot with Maxwell, Epstein, and Prince Andrew, where the prince gave her vodka and said, "Let's dance together." She says that at the end of the night, Maxwell told her Prince Andrew was coming back with them back to Maxwell's place. Ghislaine said, "He's coming back to the house and I want you to do for him what you do for Epstein," she says in the interview. I couldn't believe it. Don't forget either, Prince Pito and his buddies are telling the world that this girl is a liar and that the photo with him and his hands on her was just photoshopped. Gouffray says the encounter took place first in the bathroom and then the bedroom. He wasn't rude or anything about it. He said thank you, some kind of soft sentiment like that, and left. I couldn't believe that royalty was involved. Oh, I can absolutely believe royalty is involved. It's not surprising to me in the least. Gouffray says she and Andrew had sex two more times. The encounters happened in Epstein's New York apartment and his Virgin Islands estate, she alleges. Gouffray adds that Andrew can deny they had sex, but he knows the truth and I know the truth. A Buckingham Palace spokesperson told Dateline, "It is emphatically denied that the Duke of York had any form of sexual contact or encounter with Virginia Roberts Giuffre. Any claim to the contrary is false and without foundation." I know I say this a lot, but in Epstein's little black book, he had Scotland Yard listed as security. So could that possibly be why this creep isn't being investigated? But while we're on the subject of Prince Pedo, take a look at this piece by the Toronto Sun. Epstein: spies fear Russia has sex slave info on Prince Andrew. I hope they release everything they've got. Release it to the public. The British Secret Service fears that Russia has damaging information on Prince Andrew and his involvement with underage sex slave abusing pal Jeffrey Epstein. So if he's not guilty of anything, why are they worried, you know? According to a report in the Times of London, MI6, the UK's foreign spy agency, believes a Palm Beach County deputy sheriff who defected passed on a Prince Andrew file to the Kremlin. It's believed the information pertains to the Randy Royals' alleged sexual relationship with underage sex slave Virginia Roberts. It is claimed that she had unwanted sex with the prince when she was just 17. Unwanted sex. Trying to say rape? Why are they afraid to use this word when that's what it is? The ex-deputy, John Mark Dugan, is an American who sought asylum in Moscow in 2016. During a 2005 Florida probe into the pedophile billionaire's activities, Dugan was a member of the sheriff's department who went rogue. Epstein, who hanged himself in his New York jail cell in August, owned an oceanfront mansion in Palm Beach. Who allegedly hanged himself, I should add. I don't think it's too crazy to entertain the idea that this guy might have been taken out. We'll do an entire video on that at some point. There's a lot of interesting discrepancies going on with the entire thing. According to the Times, MI6 officials said that Dugan allegedly had contact with a senior Russian government official who was close to strongman President Vladimir Putin. He fled the U.S. after resigning in 2009 and became an anti-corruption crusader, posting lurid allegations against his former colleagues. Just before he fled, an FBI investigation into Dugan was in its embryonic stage. Dugan claimed political asylum in Russia, rebranding himself as Bad Wolf. What an utter dork. Okay, the rest of this has already been covered a lot, so we'll just kind of skip to the last one. Inside the Demon's Lair. Epstein Ranch filled with medieval relics, guns, and secret rooms. Yeah, this was his bizarre impregnation farm where the dirtbag thought he was gonna seed the human race. Pervert Jeffrey Epstein's New Mexico ranch was filled with medieval armor, stuffed animals, guns, and nude paintings. The first ever glimpse inside the deceased billionaire's sprawling Zorro horse ranch was revealed in new podcast Epstein, Devil in the Darkness, by Ian Royal, son of one of the maintenance staff who lived on the grounds. As a teenager, he would help his dad inside the convicted sex offender's lavish 26,700 square foot main residence. He explained, "There was some really high-end medieval stuff. There was a whole suit of armor. There was an observatory room with a telescope. It was like a little study." Wasn't it Virginia who described the same weird medieval stuff in these weird, kind of hidden underground rooms that he had on the island, I believe? There was this huge parlor room which almost looked like something you'd find in Sherlock Holmes. It really looked like there could have been a secret room, like if I pulled on one of the books, the shelf would move over or something. There was this room right next to the theater room with cabinets of old guns. I'm talking Civil War guns, really old rifles encased in some of these cabinets, and a room next to a kitchen. Since his death, it has been established he operated a twisted network of girls he paid to massage him, who he sexually abused and then paid, offering them more money if they brought other girls to him. In his huge New York house, Epstein had a stuffed tiger, an enormous desk, and a painting of ex-President Bill Clinton wearing a woman's dress. Epstein's Zorro Ranch was visited by a number of his famous pals, and the former lover and constant companion Ghislaine Maxwell, who helped to decorate and further showcase Epstein's eccentric tastes. Ian added, "I'm almost positive there had to have been a taxidermy lion at one point. He had a stuffed sheep in the elevator." What is wrong with these people? I would get into the elevator and be standing next to the stuffed animal, and he had beautiful furniture, and it just didn't make sense because the house was empty 80% of the time. Alright, well that about wraps it up for this video. We just wanted to do a little update on some of the stuff that you guys have been sending into us. We appreciate that. Keep it coming. We got 3 or 4 emails a day now asking about recommendations for other channels to follow for Epstein-related info, and there's a lot of them out there. But the two that I consider absolute mandatory viewing are Jamie Deluxe and Sean Atwood. So definitely go check out some of their stuff. There's links in the box below. Also, check out the poll that we have in our YouTube community center area, whatever that stupid thing is. We're trying to figure out what you guys want to see next, but we have a few other videos we've already started working on that we'll probably have to put out first. So hopefully we will see you guys then. Peace!